guys, and welcome back to my channel here, and so make sure to subscribe and leave a like on this video, and hopefully if the comments are turned on this video, if you have any questions, I would like you to write it down in the comments down below, but now anyways, let's get into this video. I'm sure you're probably wondering why I have a sling and a cast on my arm. I broke my arm yesterday, but it doesn't really matter to me that much. I mean, it'll heal up in a month, and then I won't have to wear this anymore. I mean, if you break your arm, you break your arm, you know? But anyway, let's get on to planting the seed. These three seeds here in a wet tray. They've been soaking for about 2.5-3 hours. And this is the 504 New, 974 Carbon, 925 New. And now we shall get on to the planting process. First, let's do the 504 New. I'm just going to make sure this is nice and good. But what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna put this seed and shove it right in there like that, and then cover it up. Just kind of press around the sides to make sure the seed has nice good contact with the soil. And then you wanna take whatever seed you're planting next and do the same thing. This is a slightly larger seed. So I will just put that in like that, just shove it in there and cover it up, kind of do the same thing that I did with that last one. Now let's do this one. Same exact process, shove that in there. Okay, you can see I planted all of them, and as I said before, 925 New, 974 Corbin, 504 New. I have two more planted inside in my germination container that is a tote and a heat mat. It will keep the temperature in that container, like at a nice 80, between 80 and 100 degrees. You would rather it be more low to the 90s, between 80 and 90 degrees, but if you open it like once or twice a day for like a minute or two, it will keep it down to that nice temperature you want. And at nighttime, just leave the pad on, just leave it on nighttime so that it can keep it warm at night, because at nighttime things cool down. But only do that if you are leaving your germination container outside. If it's just an inside container, you could have one that turns off at night automatically, which I have found that mine somehow does. I don't know, but and anyways, so why don't we go on inside and check out my germination container? Hello. Okay, guys. First off, I would want to say that if you ever hear any noise in the background, I have a lot of little brothers and sisters. Yeah, just like that. But anyway, let's get started on checking out my germination container. Actually, I want to say one more thing. You can see our bearded dragons. They are right there. Beardina, Beardo. They're in their cage, dirty cage.
Enjoying the sun.
And they're in the sun, as you can see. Now let's see. This is just this is my germination container. A tote with a heat mat underneath it. nice and warm inside, but it's kind of, I don't think I should be doing this with my broken arm. Enough about my heat mat and the bearded dragons. Let's check out what's inside the tote. I already only started two. Let's just try not to keep this up for too long. This is my other 504 new. And this is the other, this is my other 925 new. I planted these on Thursday. Today is Saturday, so they should be emerging soon. Or at least I hope. But anyway, now you've seen my setup. And just so you know, this setup does work, because I managed to get some other type of giant pumpkins. Like, they're not as big, but I got another type of giant pumpkins to germinate without a heating container. So it's not that hard to get big pumpkins to germinate. What I have found is it's actually a bit more difficult to manage smaller pumpkin seeds, in my opinion. And just so you know, I have had, except for one time, very bad luck trying to grow pumpkin seeds from the pumpkins you buy at the store. When you get those, they do something to the genetics so that the seeds that come from the pumpkins are, like, they're messed up and they won't grow pumpkins from them, so that you won't grow your own pumpkins. They make it so you can go and buy pumpkins from them next year. That actually makes me a little bit offended, because why don't you just go to the store, buy a pumpkin for $4 or cheaper, and then you get like 100 seeds, and you can plant, you have seeds for another 5 years before they like expire. You can save the seeds from your pumpkins that you grow every year, and it's a lot cheaper than having to buy pumpkins every year. But anyway, let's go back outside and finish the video. Well, anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. And like I said earlier in the video, please subscribe and leave a like, because I am fairly new to YouTube. Well, yeah, I am very new actually to YouTube. So, yeah, I would really appreciate it if you would leave a like and subscribe and share it with your friends. But, as you can see back here, my tomato starts, watermelons, bigger tomatoes, basil, a plant vine cutting, and the only thing, all by myself. So did I do that pumpkin patch that I have way back in the field back behind our house. And I also did some beans. I also did some tomatoes and peppers. And I will be doing these this year. And also, at the end of the year, I will be giving away seeds to whoever wants some. I will show you how. I will show you my address and stuff for mailing purposes at the end of the year, after I've dried off the seeds and I put them all in their little packets that a lot of the giant pumpkin growers use. But well, anyway. I hope you have a good day, and I'll see you next time.